2023 is looking absolutely stacked for video game releases. So let's break it down to the first half of 2023. Here are 15 new games we're looking forward to checking out. Please note, as of right now, there are a bunch of games coming out in 2023 that don't have a release date, and we're not talking about those. We're sticking to the ones that officially have a date. And also just know, a small disclaimer, all these are subject to change. Game delays happen all the time. But with that being said, let's get started off with number 15. Atomic Heart is finally soon upon us. This first-person action-adventure game, heavily inspired by the likes of BioShock, at least at a glance, just seems really, really unique with this alternate history Soviet sci-fi spin with lots of melee weapons, guns, and cool abilities in a wild and wacky world filled with weird robots. Not to mention, the game just has some really big and impressive-looking environments and just overall some pretty good graphics, at least from the trailers. Atomic Heart, though, like we said, wearing inspirations on its sleeves, could still end up being incredibly unique. We've been following this game for years at this point, back when it was just like a little Kickstarter project. And now, after, again, like I said, many delays, it's finally getting a full-fledged release February 21st, 2023. Next, over at number 14, the Dead Space remake is coming right at the start of the new year, and we have pretty high hopes for this one. Yes, it is coming from EA, who has a tendency to screw things up, but I think after Callisto Protocol, we just got that taste for gritty sci-fi survival horror in space back in our mouths. Say what you want about Callisto Protocol, loved it or hate it, it definitely left us wanting more of that style of game, and thankfully, the Dead Space remake is essentially right around the corner, although some might argue it's a game that didn't even look like it needed a remake. Visually, so far, it does seem like it looks pretty awesome. And Dead Space 1 and 2 are some incredible games, so we're looking forward to jumping back in January 27th. Next, over at number 13, we have Hogwarts Legacy. This is the big open world adventure Harry Potter game that a lot of people have been asking for a long time. It takes place many, many, many years before Harry Potter or even Fantastic Beasts and focuses on you going to Hogwarts, creating your own character, going to classes, and doing whatever you want. And there's a lot of potential for this one to be a big deal to a lot of Potter fans. It could be pretty sweet. And after a bunch of delays as well, with this one, we'll finally know February 10th, 2023. Next, over at number 12, let's talk Forspoken. I think if any game on the list, this is the one that should have an asterisk. This is the one where we're kind of cautiously optimistic because there is a demo out right now, and although we weren't super head over heels for it, we'll admit that like we just haven't seen a lot of the game, but Forspoken essentially is you as a regular person thrust into a fantasy world and given mage powers. The game focuses around a magical parkour-like traversal around open environments, questing, and combat that seemingly predominantly involves magic and casting. This Square Enix collaboration has been teased for a long time. We knew about this game before it even had the name Forspoken, and it's finally releasing after many delays January 24th, 2023. Next, over at number 11, we have Sons of the Forest. This is another long-awaited game, the follow-up to the survival game The Forest. Sons of the Forest seems like it's taking the success of the first The Forest game and putting its money where its mouth is and making a bigger, better The Forest game with a little bit more of a cinematic approach, more depth, better graphics, more mechanics. And to be honest, this one's still been shrouded in some secrecy and it's had some delays, but we're gonna see it February 23rd, 2023. Next, over at number 10, we have Street Fighter 6. Man, this one is looking pretty awesome. Some fighting game fans have already gotten their hands on it, and it seems like they're coming away impressed. And although we certainly at GameRanks do not specialize in fighting games by any means, Street Fighter is a lot of fun, and this one looks no different. Visually, it looks absolutely stunning, but it also looks like it's got the gameplay chops to back it up, and some interesting new characters. New characters that don't feel kind of like half-assed or forced. From what we've seen so far, they seem pretty sweet, and then also new creative spins on classic beloved characters that we've known for so long also look pretty cool. Capcom's big old Street Fighter 6 is dropping June 2nd, 2023. Now, next, over at number 9, we have Diablo 4. This one has been long in the works, and it's finally almost here. This Diablo is visually pretty incredible from what we've seen, from those cool cinematic movies that Blizzard is always known for to the actual gameplay itself. And it seems like they're going bigger and crazier with this. Bigger worlds, more instances, more loot, more connectivity, more playing with friends. And we're really curious to see how this one goes, because even a decent Diablo game is still pretty good. Will it top Diablo 2, a lot of us think nothing ever will, but we like to see people try. And we'll know this summer, apparently, when Diablo 4 drops June 6th. Next over at number 8, we have Wolong Fallen Dynasty. Now, in a sea of Souls-like games and Soulsborne copycats, Team Ninja and Koei Tecmo know what they're doing. They made the Neo games. So Wolong Fallen Dynasty seems to be continuing that trend with just a bigger adventure, more compelling and challenging combat, but also this time around, seemingly a really compelling and cinematic story. It's in like a fantasy spin on the Three Kingdoms period and embracing Chinese history. So it's unique, you know, it's a little different. Knowing their gameplay pedigree, I think this one, if you're into this genre, might be a safe bet. And you'll get your hands on it March 3rd, 2023. Next over at number 7, we have Company of Heroes 3. Now, although this is apparently getting a console release, Company of Heroes is definitely a PC gamer's game. And essentially with this one, and I'm using the developers' words themselves, they're just going bigger and better. This time around, it's in the Mediterranean theater and you have way more options with your units, the flexibility of what they can do, and the destruction vehicles can cause. There's gonna be a co-op skirmish mode, competitive multiplayer, and seemingly some pretty large scale battles. If you like action, tactics, and World War II history, the Company of Heroes games are pretty engaging. The average normal you might see these things and think they're boring, but I can assure you they are not. They're pretty intense. You'll get pretty sweaty. I mean, it's from the developers Relic. They know what they're doing. And this releases February 23rd. Next over at number 6, we have the Resident Evil 4 Remake. This is one that some of us here at GameRanks is our most anticipated game because it's just a remake of Resident Evil 4. That's crazy. It's something actually we never would have imagined we'd see, and here it is. So far, from what we've been able to see from Capcom, it seems like they are willing to change things up a little bit. They're going a little bit darker. They're embracing more horror, more scary elements. A lot of the game looks like it's taking place at night this time around, but also, you can still do all the wacky, crazy Resident Evil 4 stuff like roundhouse kick dudes, and now apparently parry the chainsaw guy with your knife. That for me is it, just those little things. As someone who's replayed Resident Evil 4 a million times, I'm just excited to see what little different things they might squeeze in. Where can they really flesh out Resident Evil 4? Where can they surprise us? And where can they remain really faithful and just celebrate the original game? There's a lot they can do here, and they've already done it before with Resident Evil 2 Remake, so we're just really itching to get our hands on this one, and thankfully we will. March 24th, 2023. Now, next over at number 5, speaking of the return of weird old horror games, we have Dead Island 2. Yeah, this game was announced back in like 2015 and hopped around between a bunch of developers, but now we're finally getting it. It's a real game once again with a new developer, and it's still set in like an open world California, Los Angeles type thing. So you're killing zombies in a tropical setting with melee weapons. And just from what we've seen, like the brief glimpses in the gameplay trailer, it looks like Dead Island, but it does look like fun. And honestly, at this point, we're just, pun intended, morbidly curious to just see if this game was worth the wait and all the delays and changed developers. Because at this point, I mean, the Dead Island hype has really died down, but there could be a good game here. So then we'll know for sure April 28th, 2023. Next over at number 4, we have Suicide Squad, Kill the Justice League. Man, oh man, this is Rocksteady's next game, the people behind the mainline Batman Arkham games. And this does take place in the Batman Arkham universe after Arkham Knight, where you seemingly play as the Suicide Squad tasked with taking down the Justice League because they've become corrupted. They've been turned evil. Comic book fans can really infer a lot from that, and we're just really excited to see Rocksteady's take on the Justice League. Superman, The Flash, Wonder Woman, and of course, Batman has been teased as making a return with Kevin Conroy once again voicing the character one last time. But we're just really curious to see how this game plays. They've been working on it for so long. We've gotten glimpses of gameplay, but I still have a lot of questions as to the flow and what you're generally doing. Still, we love Rocksteady's take on DC Universe stuff, so we're really in for that. Hopefully we learn more soon, but as of right now, we know the game is slated for May 26th, 2023. Hey, now next down to number 3, we have Star Wars Jedi Survivor. Respawn really killed it with Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order. In our humble opinion, they did a really good job with a Metroidvania style game and just a cool Star Wars game with satisfying combat and some neat little additions to the lore that didn't like overdo it or come off weird. It fit just right. It felt like a good old fashioned Star Wars game. And they're doing it again here, seemingly with more enemy types, way bigger worlds, more options for traversal, actual creature mounts to use, and multiple fighting stances, which the potential for that is absolutely incredible. Honestly, we're really curious to see where Cal Kestis' story can go now, especially considering in the first game, there was a decent amount of resolution to his character, although he was pretty simple. I think there's a lot they can do now here going forward. I mean, he has a blaster now, which has really cool implications for combat. Coruscant makes an appearance, which will be pretty cool, I could imagine, for gameplay purposes, if we get to jump around there. And hopefully there's just a lot of good stuff for Star Wars nerds. Like I said, Respawn did a really good job with the last game, and hopefully after that risk, now they're able to just go even crazier. As of right now, March 17th, 2023 is the date. Now down to number two, Final Fantasy 16. Man, this one looks big. This is a big old crazy cinematic action-packed Final Fantasy JRPG with more action-focused combat and seemingly a bit of a mature edge. I mean, like in the story trailers and stuff, we saw blood and just mature story themes. But thankfully, along with that, we get the traditional Final Fantasy stuff. Awesome monster summons, tons of drama, a deep story, and some incredible, I'd say downright god-tier music. At this point, with mainline Final Fantasy games, I just play them. I don't really need to know too much about them. I just love to jump into them and see what's up. And this looks like a nice, refreshing spin from 15, and I just really, really hope they nail the combat here. Final Fantasy 16 is releasing June 22nd. And now, finally, at number one, The Legend of Zelda, Tears of the Kingdom. It's been a long time since they announced the follow-up to Breath of the Wild, and now we're finally getting it. And I still have so many questions about this game, story-wise, mechanics-wise, but it seems like a very different Hyrule and gameplay with a lot more possibilities and creativity and physics-based stuff than we had in Breath of the Wild, which people really embraced. So for them to double down on that is awesome. And honestly, I've been loving how mysterious this one is. Nintendo's been pretty tight-lipped. They haven't just shown off tons and tons of the game. And at this point, I don't mind. I already bought my ticket. I'm signed up. I liked Breath of the Wild, so to get some more of that, but with a different flavor, sounds interesting. It's not often when Nintendo just straight up does a follow-up to a previous Zelda game, so they gotta have some cool ideas up their sleeves. Legend of Zelda: Tears of the Kingdom is releasing May 12th, 2023. Those are 15 new games in 2023 we're really looking forward to checking out, but of course we got some bonus games we couldn't squeeze in. The first is Ubisoft's Skull and Bones. This is releasing March 9th, and it's that kind of open world multiplayer pirate game simulator thing. It could be good, it could be terrible, who knows, but I want to check it out because I like pirate video games. And also, Like a Dragon, Ishin. The whole feudal-style Yakuza game is finally coming to the West, and I've always wanted to check out this type of thing, and thankfully now we can, February 21st. But those are a bunch of games. We make lists here, so we want to hear yours down in the comments. If you got some games in 2023 for the first half that you're looking forward to jumping into, it definitely helps us cater videos to you. But if you learned about a new game or learned anything or just had a good time, clicking a like button's all you gotta do. It really helps us out. And if you're new, consider subscribing, maybe hitting that notification bell, because we put out new videos every single day. But either way, thanks for watching. We'll see you guys next time.